welcome to the weekly market update by SoftLogic Stockbrokers. All share price index experienced a significant volatility which resulted in a new fresh high at closing. The index recorded 13,338 points, while S&P SL index closed on a flat at 4,500 levels. The weekly total turnover recorded 31.6 billion, which is 44% less than last week's turnover. The top three gainers for the week were SoftLogic Life Insurance, SoftLogic Holdings, HMB Assurance. Shares in sectors of capital goods, insurance, food and beverages, and diversified financials mostly contributed to the week's turnover. On the macroeconomic side, the President and Prime Minister flagged construction work for the second phase of the Eastern Container Terminal, mentioning $510 million USD project for completion by 2024. The project will be conducted in three phases. Standard & Poor's global rating lowers Sri Lanka's long-term sovereign credit rating due to external position being further weakened and uneven access to financing. Then, S&P highlighted further pressure on foreign exchange reserves over the coming quarters. Government of Sri Lanka stated assurance and adequate funds to repay foreign obligations, and further stated strong commitment towards the debt service payments. This includes the international sovereign bond maturity on 18 January 2022. These are the crossings for the week. January kick-started with 16,000 tourists. Tourist minister stated to expect tourists between 100,000 to 125,000 over the first quarter 2022. 12 achieved results in tourism sector. A new vaccination center was set up at the international airport to help unvaccinated visitors. Let's look at some notable company news and highlights throughout the week. The decade's largest IPO, Ella Apparel, which raised $4 billion from the public, was oversubscribed on the first opening day. Dr. Centival secured 10% of Amana Bank. Brown's Heavy Machinery and Marga Engineering joins to help Sri Lanka's infrastructure development.
Moving on to the technicals, the All Share Price Index closed the week almost unchanged from its open on Monday. The week started off with a sell-off, mostly triggered through profit-taking, and thereafter closed strong, regaining almost 200 points from what it lost during the start of the week. Looking at the overall chart, we can see the prices continue to remain above the 10-week moving average as buyers continue to dominate on the longer-term and intermediate-term timeframes. A brief look at the daily chart shows that prices are continuing to form higher highs and higher lows, and that another possible rounded base is formed, signaling that prices might likely move towards 14,000. Overall, the trend continues to remain in favor of the buyers, and thus hinting out that there is further upside potential remaining on the chart.